Okay, so we're working through our guide. We're now on FTP or SFTP, secure FTP. Maybe it's not the most exciting topic in the world, but probably most of you are going to need it at some stage. Certainly, if you're working with a developer separately or something, they're probably going to need FTP access to your site. FTP access is just giving someone or yourself direct access to the files on your site. So it could be the theme files, your plugin files. Almost anything that happens to be on there. So probably a design change or something like that, or design tweak is going to be done through FTP at some stage. Fortunately, it's very easy to set up and get access on WP Engine. You can just do it for your control panel. If I just go back to the start so you can see, I go back to the home page of this install. Okay, so here you can see all my sites. Obviously, you might only have one, but in my case, there's a few. So I'm going to click this, drill down to the individual install, and you can see here SFTP logins. You've got two types, production and staging. Production is your live site. So that's anyone who's going to it on the web is seeing. Staging, I'll cover staging a bit more. Another video after this one. Staging is just a way where you can basically make a complete copy of your site, test out new plugins, designs, any other changes on it, satisfy yourself that everything's cool, and then if you want, you can push everything to your live site production. But for now, we'll just deal with production. Okay, so when you create a new site, WP Engine automatically creates usernames for the production and the staging. As you see, you have a separate username for each one. And I think by default, the FTP is your account password or your original account password. Now, in my case, I'm just going to go ahead and set up a new password for this. So I'm just going to do, I've got this, I'm using LastPass at the moment, which stores all your passwords and things, but also can generate the kind of long, unguessable passwords. So I'm just going to use one of those for FTP because we don't want to get hacked. And hit save. Obviously, you could change it to a staging or production path. I won't worry about that. Hit save. Okay, done. And it's usually pretty instant. So I'll go ahead to your FTP software now. Now I'm using something called Coda 2 on a Mac, but you can use something like FileZilla, I think, which is free on PC and Mac. It's pretty much the same. So I'm going to go ahead and set up a new site. So I'm going to basically save the details in the FTP program, so I don't have to type in the password each time. So my cool new site, it just is my nickname. Make sure you're using SFTP mode, not FTP. The port, this is a port number. It's by default it's 22 anyway, but we're gonna put 22 in, which is what it is. Now, the server name on our dummy site, if you recall, we originally created mycoolnewsite.wpengine.com. We then associated the domain name chapmandavis.com with it. Now, when it comes to setting up your FTP, and if you're not sure, you can't remember my instructions now, you can always log into your site here in WP Admin. Click WP Engine, and at the top here you've got your SFTP details. But the important thing to remember, you need the original install name is what you need for the SFTP. So here I did my cool new site. I can't change this; it's the same for forever. So I go into FTP and I type my cool new site or whatever install name is .wpengine.com, and then username is, by coincidence, it's the same, but you could create any number of different usernames, and I'll show you how to do that for someone else in a minute. But at the moment, it's the same, so it's my cool new site. Password I just created, paste that in. I don't want it to ask me each time. And then there's a few additional settings down here, which I won't go into now, but you probably just want to set your root URL, which is the live URL of your site. I'm using Chapman Davis.com. Yours might be www dot something, but whatever. And that's it, really. We don't have to worry about these other settings right now. And Coda 2 is going to make this site. I'm going to double click it, and it should just connect to straight away. Okay, and it has, you won't see any change, but if I go to files over here and I go to you know, whichever program you're using might be different, but I'm now looking at the if I click files here, you can see the same thing. You can see the local files on the left, the server files on the right, and or remote. And here I can see all the files on the server. So most of the time you'll be doing stuff under WP content because that's got your themes and it's got your plugins. If we were to go back to a theme, I'm just currently using the default WordPress theme, which is at the moment is 2012. If I was to go to say the style sheet, I could just load that up. Here we go. And these are the styles, so I could just go in and make edits there directly. Obviously, you want to be careful if you're not sure what you're doing. So that's logging into SFTP. Just one more scenario I want to cover is just adding a login for someone else. Say you're working with another developer who needs direct access to your site. Go back here, click add login, which I just did. Name, password, confirm password. Fine, so this is a username, so you could say developer Nick, if it was me. Password, again, I'm just going to generate another password here. Make sure you confirm it. I'm just going for kind of long ones because obviously I want this to be secure. And then you have to decide if it's production or staging. You might just be production. You might need to create separate ones for both. I'm going to hit add login. So here we go. My cool new site dash developer Nick. So now if you're working with another developer or another member of your team, you would just email them these details or whatever. So they can access the site. They would go in and do exactly the same process as me, but everything would be done under this username. Why is this useful? Let's say you're working with someone just on a one-off project, or you obviously don't want everyone to have the same access. You can just set up a temporary username like this. Maybe just working, you know, with a developer for a couple of days, and then when the project's done, you can just come in here, hit delete. And sorry, I don't know if I actually clicked that. Yeah, there you go. Are you sure? Yes, I am. And we'll give it a moment. And there you go. It's refreshed and successfully destroyed, not deleted, destroyed, in fact. So this way you don't have to obviously share your main password with someone else. And that's SFTP.